गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट, आई एम ओवी आशीष कांबळे, द असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स फ्रॉम कॉम्प्युटर सायन्स डिपार्टमेंट. वेलकम टू अवर ई लर्निंग प्लॅटफॉर्म. इन अ प्रीवियस व्हिडिओ वी डिस्कस द शॉर्ट रेंज वायरलेस टेक्नॉलॉजी अँड लोकेशन ट्रॅकिंग सिस्टीम, दॅट इज GPS. इन दिस व्हिडिओ वी गो टू द अनदर चॅप्टर 3 ऑफ वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन अँड इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स, विच इज IoT आर्किटेक्चर. In this video, we discuss some points. Those are, what is IoT, how big it is, history of IoT, how it works, example of IoT device, M2M and or IoT, advantages, disadvantages and applications. What is IoT? In the decade year 1990 to 2000, internet connectivity began to a start in enterprise and consumer market, but was still limited in its use because of low performance of network interconnectivity. From the year 2000, internet connectivity goes superior for many applications. Today, we have many options to get interconnectivity, not only in office, home, but at in pocket with the smartphone and laptop, etc. Everyone is aware of use of internet with connectivity from World Wide Web, that is www, browsing, and lot of information is available for many enterprise, industrial and consumer product, government services, educational services and many more on www. Now the concept of Internet of Things is IoT, which is an interconnected network of machines an application that we use in our daily routine life. In short word or in simple word, we can say that the Internet of Things referred to a system of interrelated, interconnected objects that are able to connect and transfer data over a wireless network without human intervention. The Internet of Things is a catch-all terms for a growing number of electronics that aren't traditional computing devices but are connected to the internet to send data, receive instruction or both. Next, how big it is? In a word, there are more than 50 billion IoT devices as of in year 2020, and those devices will generate 4.4 gigabytes of data in this year. What is mean by gigabytes? Gigabytes is a trillion gigabytes. By comparison, in 2013, IoT devices generated a mere 100 billion gigabytes. The amount of money to be made in the IoT market is similarly swelling estimate on the value of market in year 2025 range from $1.6 trillion to $14.4 trillion. Next, history of IoT. A world of omnipresent connected devices and sensors is one of the oldest trope of science fiction. IoT core has double a vending machine at Carnegie Mellon that was connected to apparent in 1970 as the first Internet of Things device. And many technologies have been tested and embedding smart IoT style characteristics to give them a fantastic scheme. But the term Internet of Things was coined in 1999 by the British technologist Kevin Ashton. This is a diagram of history of IoT. In year 1982, Carnegie Mellon researchers connect a vending machine to the internet remotely to check for cold soda. In 1990, the first toaster was operated over a net. In 1999, the term Internet of Things was coined by the Kevin Ashton. In 2000 year, LG introduced first smart fridge. In 2004, first smartwatch introduced. In 2007, Apple Smart iPhone and wearable Fitbit release. In 2009, Google start testing self-driven car. In 2011, Smart TV is introduced. In 2013, Google Lens is released. In 2014, Echo caused a share in smart home market. And in 2015, Tesla comes out with a autopilot driven for their cars. Now, the private moment in IoT market evolution. In 2014, the year of count things. In 2015, the year of the IoT platform. 2016, the year of IoT developer. In 2017, the year of consumer conditioning. In 2018, the year of standard realization. In 2019, the year of several major security attacks. And in 2020, IoT is the new IT. Next is how it works. The basic element of IoT are devices that gather data. Broadly speaking, they are internet connected devices, so they each have their separate IP address. The range is complexity from autonomous vehicle that haul product around a factory floor to simple sensor that monitor the temperature in a building. To make the data useful, it need to be collect, process, filter, and analyze, each of which can be handled in a variety of ways. Collecting the data is done by transmitting it from the device to gathering point. The data can be sent over the internet to the data center or cloud that has storage and compute power, or the transfer can be staged with intermediately device aggregating the data before sending it along. Processing the data can take place in data center or in a cloud, but sometimes that's not in an option. The round trip time for sending data, processing it, analyzing it, and returning instruction can take too long. In such case, edge computing can come into a play where a smart gauge device can aggregate data, analyze it, and fashion response if necessary, all within relatively close physical distance, thereby reducing delay. This is a diagram which shows how the Internet of Things works. The Internet of Things work in a 3-step. First, IoT device gather the data and send it through the internet for processing. Then, data is analyzed at center. Centrally, the data can be analyzed. And in third, instruction base is analyzed or returned to the devices. Next, example of IoT devices. Smart home appliances, RFID tag, and industrial sensor are the example of IoT devices. Other example, we can say that fitness wearable and home security system, that is a Raspberry Pi and Arduino. Some practical example we can consider as smart refrigerator, smart phone, smart car, smart TV, and smart home, and many more. These are the example of IoT devices. Next, M2M and or IoT. Machine to machine, that is M2M. Machine to machine communication or M2M is exactly as it sounds, two machines communicating or exchanging data without human interface or interaction. Without human interface or interaction, the data can be sent from one place to the another place, which is called as machine to machine or M2M communication. Switching over a wireless has made M2M communication much easier and enabled more applications to be connected. M2M is a simple device-to-device communication, usually within an embedded software at user site. It is isolated system using some standard with restricted scalability option. M2M communication is big data analysis and machine learning technique are major building block when it comes to the definition of IoT. This is the diagram of M2M and IoT comparison of M2M and IoT. In M2M, we can send data or exchange our information from machine to machine. That is, from car to machine, from machine to machine, from home to machine. And in Internet of the Things, we can send or exchange our information from machine to machine through a internet. We can see that. We can see here. This is the internet, and we can exchange data from one machine to the car through a internet. Similarly, from machine to machine through internet. Similarly, from home to machine or machine to home through the internet. Advantages. Next slide is advantages of IoT. IoT improve communication between the devices. Next, automation and various control mode possible by using IoT. It save time and of course money by IoT. Disadvantages of IoT. Complexity of the system. The system of IoT is complex. The privacy and security of transmission of data is less as compared to other transmitting the devices. By using the IoT, the privacy and security of transmission of data is less. Compatibility of software and hardware is survive of system. These are the disadvantages. Next, application. The IoT system can be used in smart home, healthcare, consumer electronics, smart cities, automobile, wearable device, and in agriculture field also. Thank you. Thank you for watching my video. Keep watching my video.